Hello everyone. So welcome to Unacademy. So my name is Riya Agarwal and I teach live on Unacademy Plus. So I'll tell you a little about Unacademy Plus before we begin today's class, which is based on data table from the data interpretation section. Okay, so we are starting this conceptual course for CAT 2019. So let's proceed. Hello Dith. Okay. So about live classes, so these are live classes like this where we can interact and doubts can be cleared immediately. So these are all live and structured courses which are taken by all top educators. So like I take only DILR for CAT. So you will find other teachers like it's a subscription based model, so wherein you don't have to purchase separate course for separate subjects. You just pay at one place a minimal value and you can see the lessons by all top educators. Okay. Also, it includes weekly quizzes and separate doubt clearing sessions. Fine. So, let's see what is it. So, for 1 month subscription, for 1 month, you will have the validity to check all the teachers' lessons in 1 month. Okay, so the price is rupees 3000 for per month. If you go for 6 months payment together, then you have to pay only 2250 per month and 1500 per month if you pay for 12 months together. So these courses will be running throughout till CAT exam and even after that for the other preparation sections like for personal interview and GD etc. Okay, so therefore you can either go for a 6 month or 12 month course. That will be better option, and also you get an additional 10% discount if you use the referral code IRIAAGARWAL.
Okay, if you use this as a referral code while checking out, you get an additional 10% off.
Fine, so let's proceed and begin our course for today. Conceptual course on data interpretation and logical reasoning for CAT 2019. Today we are seeing only data table, not caselet, okay? So what is data interpretation? Data interpretation or data analysis, as the name is telling us, it is all about data. And if we look at our life scientifically, we can say that our life is all about data, because in our day-to-day life, we use lot of data from sales reports to trends to budget planning to almost every single operation. Some or other calculations is required. And in this section, we explore those calculations. Okay, and the basic idea why this section is given to you as a part of this examination, this competitive examination, is to test your ability to make decisions and find the right way, find the right path to reach the answer in any situation. Okay, in different situations. So it's like one word here is data. So it's all about data. Second word here is interpretation, which is also a very important word. So you should learn how to interpret the data. If you learn that, then you will be able to solve any question in data interpretation. Okay, it's only about interpretation. Interpretation means analyzing and understanding what have been given to you and what is being asked. If you know these two things clearly, you will be able to answer what is being asked. Okay, so let's see. These are the structure of questions that may be asked in data interpretation. So it can be based on a data table, bar chart, XY chart, pie chart, or caselets which have data. So data table we are starting now. We'll study bar chart later, which is a chart like this, bar graph. And then we will study XY and line graph, pie chart, and then cases. Cases means the information, instead of giving the data in the in some format like this, they will give it in a paragraph form. So that is known as a caselet. So let's proceed and see the table's topic in detail. Let's begin. So there is no much theory, just what are tables. Let's see that and then we can begin with the questions. So tables are basically a chart of facts and figures shown in horizontal rows and vertical columns. Okay, so horizontal, these things are known as rows and vertical columns. Okay, and a table is the most versatile method of systematic representation of quantitative data. Why? One point is that a lot of data can be accumulated in a table. Okay, unlike other formats, So see, in a bar graph, you can take maybe 4 bars at one this thing, then again 4 bars, or maybe 5, but you cannot take like n number of data, right? While in a table, you can take as many rows you want, as many columns you want. So therefore, much information can be fit in a table than in any other form. Secondly, it is versatile. Why? Because any of the other formats, from caselet to bar graph, XY chart, pie chart, anything can be converted to a data table. Okay, so therefore, then if it is converted to a table, it can be solved with ease. Okay, the data represented in any form can be converted to a table for ease. So your complete data interpretation can be taken care of if you learn two things. One is to solve the table's topic clearly. Okay, how the data is given to you in a very, very straightforward manner, right? Everything is neatly arranged and given to you. But still, you should learn how to interpret the questions and solve them. So once we learn that, we will later learn how to convert other formats into tables. So that once we do that, we can solve any question in data interpretation. Okay. So let's proceed. Key skills involved is, number one, you have to read the figures closely and establish a relationship with it. What does this mean? Establish a relation with the table. Means you should see the table. You should take few seconds, few minutes to establish a relation with the table. Establish, understand what have been given to you. That is very important. If you just see the table and leave it and rush to the questions and then try to come back and look for the answer, it becomes really difficult. But if you read the figure closely beforehand, if you know what is given to you, then you can make correct use of it. Okay, if you want to use something, you should know what you have. Okay, similarly, if you first see the table, read it clearly, know what you have, then you can use it cleverly while solving the questions. When you read the question, you will know, okay, this question needs only this much data and I should look only for that data in this part of the table. And I'll not bother about how much ever big the table is. Clear? So that is what I mean. So take 1 to 2 minutes in the beginning and read the given figure closely. Talk to yourself about what is given to you so that you can save some time later. If you don't do that, if you straight away rush to the questions, you will in fact take more time than saving any time. Okay, just try and see it. Number two, we should not over approximate any data just to simplify our task, any calculations. We should not over approximate it. Okay, so approximation sometimes is fine, but then you should know when can you approximate and how much can you approximate. But still not too much, not over approximation. Okay, so I'll teach you this when and how much while we are solving the questions. Number three, do not assume any information that is not given in the question. So this is very, very important point. You should never assume any information, whether in data interpretation or in logical reasoning. Okay, and data interpretation is all about arithmetic and calculation speed. Focus and practice is all we need to master it. So we will proceed and see the questions now. So, Lokesh, for logical reasoning, see, if you are weak in logical reasoning, what you can do in the beginning, you can start practice from anywhere on the net. So many questions are available. So you can start practice from anywhere. Just pick a few questions and try to solve it how much ever time you are taking. Okay, don't bother about the timing for now. Just focus that, just try that you have to solve the question yourself. Okay, so what will happen? You will develop that ability to think logically. Once you do that, you can work on your timing later. Okay, also if you want, you can refer to my profile on Unacademy, where you can find, I have put very basic problems for people who want to start from the beginning. Okay, there you will find lessons which are free of cost. You can go and watch them, and those starts problem at a very basic level. So I think that will help you. So you can just check it out once on Unacademy. Just type my name and you can find my profile. There you will find different conceptual topics, like for sitting arrangement, there is a separate course where some lessons are there, some problems are there, basic problems, okay, which will help you to enhance your logical reason, to develop that logical ability so that later you will be able to solve the tougher problems. Okay, so separate courses are there for sitting arrangement, quantitative reasoning, puzzles, everything. You can find it there. Okay, also you can practice from any book, any material, anywhere. Okay, just practice for the sake of developing that logical reasoning in your mind. Let's see problem one. So study the following table and answer the questions based on it. Expenditure of a company in lakh rupees per annum over the given years is given to us. Okay, so 1998, 99, 2000, 2001 and 2002. For these 5 years, the expenditures of a company in lakh rupees per annum have been given. Okay, so we see expenditure are on these items, that is number one, salary, then fuel and transportation cost, bonus, interest on loans and taxes. So these are the 5 areas where expenditure have been done by a company. Okay, so we will, so there is nothing else, just the expenditure things are there. And these values are in lakh rupees. So this is 288 lakhs, 3 lakhs, 23.4 lakhs, 83 lakhs. Okay. So I have understood what is given to me. Now I will go to the questions. In the question I see, if I just don't read all the questions, just glance through it. So I see that average amount of interest. So I, what will I do for this? For this I will focus only on this interest. For this. Okay, for this I need to focus only on the interest column. Okay, only on the interest column. I need to take the total and divide it by 5 to get the average, right? So I will need the total for interest on loans. Next, and remaining table is not necessary. Remaining data is not necessary for this particular question. Now let's see question number 2. So there we need total amount of bonus paid. For that again, I have to take the total of bonus. And then the total amount of salary, that I have to take the total and then I have to find the percentage. Okay. Again, in third question, they're talking about total expenditure on all these items. Question number 4, they are talking about total expenditure during the year 2000. And here they are talking about 2002 and 1998. So you see in most of the questions, they are talking about the total. Total expenditure on taxes, total on fuel and transport. So we see indirectly they have asked us to take the total of each and everything. For salary in one question, fuel and transport in another question, bonus in one question, interest on one question and taxes in one question. So we require the total in all this case. So if you want, you can just glance and find this out and then take the total before you start solving. So that what you, happens if you do that, then you will take only hardly 2 minutes to solve all the 4 questions. Once you have this, only 5 questions if you have this total with you. Okay, that is one way, or we will do it while we are solving the questions. So what is the average amount of interest per year which the company had to pay during this period? Hi Akash. So we are solving this question. You can try to solve it yourself as well, side by side, and you can give me the answers if you want to. Okay. So here we'll add all these values, these 5 values, and take the by 5. This 5 values sum by 5 will give us the average amount of interest per year. Okay. So we have the total as 6 plus 4, 10, 19, 23, 3, 2. Okay, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 and 9 is 17, 23, 3, 2, 2, 2, 4, 7, 4, 11, 11, 18. So we have got 183.3 divided by 5. Okay, so we see here the values are close to each other. Okay, 32.43, 33.72, 34.18 and 36.66 lakhs. So try not to take any approximation here because the values are close. Okay. Hi, Nikesh. Suraj, have got the answer as D. Let's check. So 5, 3 is 15. Then 6 is 30, 6 is 30. Okay. Again 6. So it's 36.66 lakhs, option D. Okay, next question. Question number 2, the total amount of bonus paid by the company during the given period is approximately what percent of the total amount of salary paid during this period. So we first forget everything, we just need the total of bonus and total of salary. So let's take that first. So we have 8 and 2, 10, 6 and 4, 10, so 20, 0, 2, 5, 8, okay, 8 into 10, and 6 and, okay, 30, this is 0, 3, so we have 3, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, so we have got 17 lakhs as bonus. Now let's take the salary total, so we get 8 into 10, 20, 0, 8 into 10, 10, 14, 15, 16, 17, 19, 20, 21, 1, 2, 2, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So we have got 1710 and 17. Okay, Nadir, have you got this answer for this question? Or question number 2 or 1? Okay, so we now need to take what is the amount of bonus paid by the company. Okay, take this as X. Amount of bonus paid by the company during the given period is approximately what percent of Y? X is what percent of Y? The formula to find this is X by Y into 100. Okay, X is what percent of Y? You find it by X by Y into 100. So we have 17 as X and 1710 as Y. Okay, now you see here, if you take a little approximation, that is if you make this as 1700 and you will get 1. Okay, even if it was 1710, you would have got 0.999 something. So it doesn't matter, right? Here it is not affecting. So here you can take this little approximation. It won't hurt and you will get the right answer. That is option C. Okay. Question number 3. It's 1%, not 0.1. So option C. Okay, third question. The total expenditure on all these items in 1998 was approximately what percent of expenditure in 2002? So again, this X percent of Y, we need to find where X is the total in 1998. What will that be? So try solving this yourself. 288 plus 98 is 386. 386 plus 83. Okay, plus 3 is 389. 389 plus 83 is 2173. No, not 3, 4. 472 plus 23.4. So that is 4594. So we have got 495.4. For 2002, we have got as 420 plus 98 will be 520. 518. 518 plus 142 is 0166. 660 plus 49.4. 9.4 0 7 0 9.4 plus 3.96 so this is 6 3 1 3 1 7 7 1 3.36 7 1 3.36. Now we have to take X by Y. So 495.4 divided by 713.36. Can we take the approximation here? So we see the values are close only. It's 62, 66, 69 and 71. 713.36 into 100%. Okay, so maybe we can take it as 495 and 715. So we have 59 and 59. And here we have 515453. Okay. This is approximately total expenditure on all these items in 1998 was approximately what percent of the total expenditure in 2002? So approximately this will be around 70. It's better we take the exact value only. 7134 95 00. So we get into 7 7 3 is 15 5 1 7 1 is 7 8 7 7 is 49. So we see this is slightly greater, so it will be not 7 but 6, because you see here it's 50 and it's 85, so it have exceeded by 35, so it means it will be 69 point something. So from here we have got the answer as C. Okay, no need to solve exactly. Nikesh, you can find by link also. It's unacademy.com/IRIA Agarwal. Okay, question number 4. The total expenditure of the company over these items during the year 2000 is. The total expenditure of the company during the year 2000. Here you don't have to do anything, just add all the values of 2000. So we have 324 plus 101, this. 324 plus 101 will be 425. 425 plus 74 is 499 plus 41.6 is 0.45. 540.6 plus 3.84. So we get 544.44. Option A. Next, question number 5. The ratio between the total expenditure on taxes for all the years and the total expenditure on fuel and transport for all the years respectively is approximately. So first take the total and then we will take the ratio. Total of taxes will be 888 is 24, 24 plus 4 is 28, plus 3 is 31, 1, 3. 10 plus 8 is 18, plus 7 is 25 plus 20 is 45. So we have got 451 and what is that? Fuel and transport. So this will be 8 into 10, 10, 16, 6, carry 1, 9, 10. 10 plus 11 is 21, 21 plus 10 is 31, 31 plus 27 will be 38, 48, 58, 586. So we have got 451 divided by 586. We have to take ratio, so we are just dividing, we are not multiplying into 100% because we don't need the value in 100%. So here we can take a little approximation, we can make this as 0 from 1 and make this as 5 from 6. So we have 590 515157. Will this go by anything? Yes, it goes by 3. So 3 3s are 9, 3 9s are 27, 30, 10, 30. So we have got 10 is to 30. Option B. Okay. Next. Problem number 2. So again we have been given a table. Number of workers working in various departments of Bharat Petroleum have been given. Okay, from 2003 to 2008, and different departments name have been mentioned. Exploration, health, maintenance, safety and environment, finance department. So we see these are number of workers. Okay. Fine. So we see here again in the questions, if we scan through the question, you will see total number of workers, total number, total employees, total number of workers, total workers, ratio of workers working. So everywhere we need the total, right? We need the total everywhere. So what do we do? So this question I'll show you how to solve by taking the total in the beginning. Okay, so here we will take the total in the beginning first. So you can add these values and take the total first, and then we will solve the question. So you will see that how quickly we are able to solve the questions if we do that. Okay, so quickly first do this. 150 plus 50 is 200. 200 plus this 100. So 300. 300 plus 45 is 345. Next, 225 plus 45 is 270. 270 plus 70 is 340. 340 plus 102 will be 442. Next, 450 plus 90 is 540. 540 plus 65 is 605. 705, 705, 705, 708. Okay, similarly we will go on doing this. 470 plus 30 is 502. 502 plus 3 is 505, 575 plus 70 will be 645 plus 5 is 650, 750. Okay, next, 500, 580, 654, 754, 756, 786, 786 plus 35. 786 plus 35 will be 850. 786 plus 35 is 1, 1, 2, 8, 20. 505 plus, this is 175 plus 150 is 150 plus 180 plus 580 785 785 plus 36 will be same 821. Okay, similarly we can do the calculations on this side. 500 500 1000 1600 1600 plus 600 plus 700 1600 plus 700 will be 2300. Okay, this way 5 5 10 5 15 18 8 1 6 4 10 10 plus 15 is 25 25 plus 10 is 35, then 50 30 80 80, or 5 5 10 and 6 16 18 8 carry 1 5 5 10 10 and 12 22 to 28. This side 5 5 10 14 4 1 4 5 11 11 plus 9 is 20 30 40 50 56. 5 5 10 7 1 7 into 6 is 42 43 437. So we have got all the total values. So we will take this and use this now to solve the question. Nadir, we are seeing the basics now. It's very important to develop the basics first, because after that you will be able to solve any problems. So there are more students who are just beginning the preparation. So to match them, I've just started from the beginning. Therefore, I've taken this easy problems first. Because in these, we are not learning anything. We are not learning like to solve CAT level problems. But we are learning how to solve it. Basics. Okay, what to do. So those things are also important to be able to solve tougher questions later. Okay. Which year had the total number of workers equal to the number of workers the factory had in the year 2007? So now we can you see the answer? Even without using a pen, you can tell the answer is 2008. Because we see that total number of workers is same for 2007 and 8. So the correct answer is option A. Next, question number 2. Which department had the total number of employees equal to 298? So we see it is maintenance department. Option C. Question number 3. which year had the number of workers working in finance department more than 20% of the total workers? So here we see total is 345. So 20% will be close to 70, but this is 75 in finance department. So this year will be counted. So it is there in the option. So 2003 is the answer. Let's check other. I'll show you that those will not be the answer. 2006, we can see 20% of 750 will be around 150, but this is only 70. Then in 2005, again 20% of this will be around 140. This is 73. 20% of this will be around 160, but this is not there. Yes, you can share it. We'll discuss it in the next class then. Next class is anyways of different topic, but if you want, we can just discuss one or two questions there. It's fine. Okay, so later in the comment section, you can share it. I'll take it from there for tomorrow's class. Question number 4. What was the ratio of workers working in health department in 2004 to employees working in safety and environment department in 2007? Okay. So in 2004, we see a number of... In 2004, in health department, there are 40 workers, and in safety and environment in 2007 there are 132. So we need to take this ratio. So we take 33. So 10 is to 33. Option A is the correct answer. Okay, fifth question. What was the average number of workers working in the exploration department during the year 2003 to 2008? Exploration department total is 2300, so average will be 2300 by 5 or 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay, 6 years. Nadir, I'll give you my email address, you can share it there, okay. gmail.com. Okay, so we have 2300 by 6, so that will be how much? 63 is 18. Then we have 5 left, 50. 50 means 6, 8 is 48, 20 will be left, again 3 is 18. So we have 383, option B as the correct answer. Okay, next. So we see you, what did you saw here? So we were able to solve all the questions quickly because we had the total. Otherwise, in each question you needed to take the total. So I've shown you two questions with both methods. You can go ahead with whatever you wish to. Okay, problem 3. A school has 4 sections A, B, C, D of class 9 students. So, students who have failed in both exams, the result of half yearly and annual exams are shown below. These are the number of students who have failed in both exams from 4 different sections. Sections A, B, C and D. Okay. Then these are the number of students who have passed in annual exams but failed in half yearly for each section. Again, these are the number of students who have passed in half yearly but failed in annual exam. And these who have passed in both the exams. Okay. So let's begin the questions. Question number 1. If the number of students passing an examination be considered a criteria for comparison of difficulty level of the two exams, which means if suppose more students have passed in the half yearly, it means half yearly exam was less difficult than annual exam. Okay, that is what they mean. First, it's very important for you to understand the language of the problem, to understand what the question is asking. Because only if you know what is being asked, you can answer it, right? So therefore, it's important that you understand the question before you answer it. So for this, you have to develop that habit of continuously keep talking to yourself. So that will also help you to keep your focus in place. Okay, so that your focus does not go here and there. You can have a practice of this thing of talking to yourself. When you read a line, tell yourself what did you just read, what simplify it and tell it to yourself. Okay. If the number of students passing an examination be considered a criteria for comparison of difficulty level of the two examinations, which of the following statements is true? So for this, we need to find out how many students have passed in half yearly and how many have passed in annual exam. Once we know that, we can answer the question. Okay. So these students who have passed in both the exam have to be included in both of these count. The count for those who have passed in half yearly from all the sections and those who have passed in annual exam from all the sections, the total count have to be taken, right? So those who have passed in both the exams will be counted in both of these, in half yearly and in annual exam as well. Okay, and then apart from them, in half yearly these will also be counted because these have passed in half yearly but failed in annual exam. And in annual exam, these will counted because these have passed in annual exam but failed in half yearly. These will not be counted in any of them because they have all failed. Clear? So here we have what? Add these values. For half yearly, we will add 6 plus 17 plus 9 plus 15. Also, we have to add these 4 and add it to this and this. But if we are just comparing, if we don't add this, then also it's fine. Suppose this total is X. Then this X has to be added here and added here as well. Right? So it doesn't matter if we add it or not. We can just compare the other values. Instead of wasting time on calculating the total here, we can just leave it. So this we will get 14 plus 12 plus 8 plus 13. 12 plus 8 is 20, 30, 40, 47. So we got 47 plus 6. Here what we'll get? 17 plus 6 plus 9 is 15. 15, 15, 30. 30 plus 17 is 47. So here also we have got 47 plus 6. So we see both the values are equal. In half yearly and annual exam, both the values are equal. If both the values are equal, it means equal number of students have passed both the exam, which means the difficulty level was same for both the exams. Both the examinations had almost the same difficulty level. Okay. Next question. Question number 2. So जो fail हुआ वो ही exam difficult होगा, यानी कि जो जिसमें ज़्यादा pass हुआ वो exam कम difficult होगा, right? वो ही हमने किया ना. See, we took number of students who have passed in half yearly. We have took number of students who have passed in half yearly and number of students who have passed in annual exam. Okay, फिर हमें मिला कि वो दोनों values क्या है, equal है, यानी कि both exam had the same difficulty level. क्योंकि बोथ एग्जाम्स में इक्वल बच्चे पास हुए. इफ यू वांट टू चेक इट एज द नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स हु हैव फेल्ड, यू विल गेट द सेम आंसर ओनली. ओके, इफ यू वांट टू गो दैट वे, दैट नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स हु हैव फेल्ड, देन व्हाट विल यू डू फॉर हाफ ईयरली. फॉर half yearly, those who have failed, you will take it as failed in half yearly. So we will take these values. Again, if you take the sum of these values, you will get 47. Plus, we will add the total of these values now because we need the total of who have failed. Let us take this as y. So 47 plus y we will get. And for annual, these students have failed in annual. So we will again take the total and what will we get? We will get 47 only plus y. So again, the values are same only. Whether you go by number of students you have passed or number of students you have failed, you will get the same answer. Okay, question number 2. How many students are there in class 9 in the school? So for this, you have to just take the total. Total of all these numbers. Okay, total of all these numbers. So add all these like this first and then add these four numbers. Okay. So we'll get option D, 430. Next question. Which section had the maximum pass percentage in at least one of the two examinations? at least one of the two examinations and maximum pass percentage which section had it. So we need to now find it section wise. Okay, section wise we need to find it. Let's see. So we see in section A passed in at least one of the exam, and then we will also need the total of all these number of students in section A. So total of number of students in section A will be 8, 6, 4, 10, 10, 18, 2, 2, 2, 2, 4, 5, 5 and 6 is 11. 112 is the total here. For section B, we have the total as 7 and 3, 10, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, next. 7, 8, 15, 15 plus 9 is 24, 24 plus 6 is 30, 0, 3, 3, 4, 4 plus 4 is 8. So this is 80, and here we have 7 and 3, 10, 1, carry 2, 2, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 2, 2, 4, 5, 6, 6 and 7 is 30, and 31. Okay. So now we will take the number of students who have passed in section A. So passed will be passed in at least one of the two examinations. Okay, passed in at least one of the two examinations. So we will take these students and this. Because these have passed only in one, that is annual. These have passed only in one, that is half yearly. These have passed in both. Why are we taking the ones who have passed in both? Because it's given at least one. At least one means one or more. Okay, therefore we will also take. Therefore, we will also take this one. Okay, so from 112, we have to just subtract 28 and take it. So we will have 112 minus 8 is 104. 104, 94, 84. So we have 84 by 112. B, it will be 107. 84 by 107. C, it will be 80 minus 17 is 70, 63. 63 by 80. And D, we have 131 minus 27, that is 104 divided by 131. Okay, now we see that these two values in the numerator is same, but denominator is greater for this, which means A will be lesser than B. Okay, no need to find exact values, just compare. So we have got that A is less than B, which means A cannot be the answer. Okay, we need the maximum pass percentage. Then next, if we compare this with we cannot compare it, the values are not like entirely different. So what will we do? We will approximately find the values. So 107 and 87, what will this be? So this will not even be 0.7 around, right? This will become 840. So can we take into 8? No. So it will be around 0.79 something. This one will be around 0.63. So again 0.7 something. We need to means find exactly. Okay, this will also be around 0.79 something, because 64, if it would have been, then it would have been 0.8 only, right? Then this one is 131, 104, 0. So we will have into 9 or 8 at least. 8 into 1 is 8, 8, 3 is a 24, 4 carry 2, 8, 1 is a 8, 9, 10. So 1048. Again, this is also close to 0.79. So what do we do? We need exact values. So you will have to still do exact calculations. So here we see 749, and this is 840. So this will be like 910. So that will be into 8. So we have got 0.78. Okay, while this is, let's take it again, 8063. So 0.7 is 56. Okay, then we will get 40 and 30, 70. So 700. 80 into 8. 80 into 8 something will be 640. It cannot be 9 because that will be 720. So here also we are getting 0.8. Let's see for D, if we are getting 7.9 exactly, then that is the correct answer. Okay, because for D, okay, so this is only 8 less, so I think we'll get here 7.9. So D is the correct answer. So values were very close to each other, therefore some extra calculation was required here. Okay, which section has the maximum success rate in annual exam? So only for annual exam we have to take upon total. So total we already have, it's 112, 107, 80 and 131. So for section A, section A annual exam, passed in annual exam, these passed in annual exam. So we have 64 plus 14, that is 78. Okay, next 55 plus 12 is 67. Next 46 plus 8 will be 54. 54 by 80. And 76 plus 13 is 89 by 131. So again we can just compare and check the values and we'll again get the answer as option okay, we need the maximum success rate. So here you can check the options, check the answer. Question number 5, which section has the minimum failure rate in half yearly exam? A, B, C, D, 112, 107, 80 and 131. So minimum failure rate in half yearly exam. So failure rate means we have to take the ones who have failed in half yearly. 14 plus 28. Okay, it's 38, 40. 2 by 112. Then for B we will take 35 by 107. 8 plus this 25 by 80 and 27 plus 13, 40 by 130. Okay, who have failed in half yearly exam, we have taken that number and we need to find the minimum value. So we see that answer is option D again. Next, problem number 4. So we have been given some values, events. Some events are given: gymnastics, pole vault, high jump, long jump, judo, 100 meter race, short put and swimming. And some states are given: Odisha, Punjab, Gujarat, Kerala, Assam and Tamil Nadu. So then some numbers are given. So there is no other information. Let us see from the question. Okay, so these are the number of players. The number of players from different states have been given to us. 10 players from Odisha participated in gymnastics and so on. So let's see the questions. Question number 1. The number of players from Gujarat who participated in swimming is what percent more than the number of players who participated in 100 meter race from the same state? Okay. So from number of players from Gujarat who participated in swimming is 15. So 15 is what percent more? They are asking X is what percent more than Y? Then the answer for this will be X minus Y divided by Y into 100%. Okay, so X we have got as 15. What percent more than the number of players who participated in 100 meter race from the same state, from Gujarat only? So there are 6. So 5 minus 6 by 6 into 100. So we have 9 by 6 into 100. So we see that numerator is greater than denominator. Therefore, the value will be more than 100%. So these three values, you can cancel it. It's not 75, 90 or 100 and 100. So let's see what it is. 3 threes are, 3 twos are 50, 150. Option C. Okay. Question number 2. What is the average number of players who participated in high jump from all the states together? High jump. Average number of players we need. So 20 and 20, 40. 40 and 20, 60, 60 and 30, 90. So there are 90 divided by number of states are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 90 divided by 6 will be 15. Okay, option A. Question number 3. What is the ratio of total number of players from Assam who participated in all the games to the number of players who participated in long jump from all the states together? You have to take this total and Assam total and take the ratio. Okay. So we have 12 plus 8, 20, 30, 30, 40, 50, 50 plus 13. 50 plus 13 is 63. 63 plus 9 is 72. 72 plus 9 is 81. So we have got 81, all the players from Assam, and all the players who participated in long jump will be 14. So we have 12 plus 13, 25 plus 15, 40, 50, 51, 62. 81 by 62, correct? This is what we have. Okay, so we have 9 into 8. So 9 is to 8. Option C is the correct answer. Question number 4. The number of players from Punjab who participated in shot put is what percent of the number of players from Odisha who participated in 100 meter race? Punjab in short put is 18 and Odisha in 100 meter race is 8. So they are asking number of players. So X is what percent of Y? So X is what Punjab? So 18 by Y is 8 into 100%. Again, this will be greater than 100%. Okay. In fact, it will be greater than 200% because 18 is more than double of 8. Okay. So, what will we have? 4, 2, 4, 25. 1, 9. So, this is 225%. 25% option E. Question number 5. The average number of players who participated from Odisha taking all the games together is what percentage of the average number of players who participated from Tamil Nadu taking all the players together? Okay, average number of players who participated from Odisha. So instead of taking the average in both the case, because for taking the average, we have to divide it by the same number, right? What are the number of events? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So to take the average in case of Odisha also, we have to divide it by 8. In case of Tamil Nadu also, we have to divide it by 8. And then anyways, we are taking the percentage of the two. So those average will get cancelled. Okay, so we don't convert it to the average. We'll just take the total and find the answer. So let's see. 10, 20, 20 is 50. 50 plus 20 is 70. 70 plus 30 is 100. 115. Next, for Tamil Nadu, we have 20. 20 plus 30 is 50. 50 plus 10, 60, 60 plus 10, 70, 75, 75, 85, 85 plus 7, 92. So this is what we have got, right? Okay. So what is the number of Odisha first? Okay, 115 is what percent of the average number of people who participated from Tamil Nadu? So Tamil Nadu is 92 into 100. So again, the total will be more than 100%, but not more than 200. So this is cancelled, more than 100, this is cancelled. So the value have to be one among these, 110, 125 or 130%. So let's see. 92, does it go by something? 7, 22, no. 6, 32, no. And can we take approximation? If we take what, if we take it, this as 90, so this and this will be cancelled. No, it's better we also solve it. Okay, 105, 0, 0, 92. So we have 1, 92, 3, 2, 230. So 2 we will take, 184. So we have 6. 22 minus 18 is 4. 460. 460 will take 5. So we are getting 125%. Option D. Okay, let's see problem number 5 quickly. So data related to number of employees who joined or and left 5 companies during the given years. Consider the company started in 2001. Okay, so in 2001 only the company started, so nobody left in the same year. Okay, these were the number of people that joined the different companies in 2001. Then in 2002, some people started leaving the company. Okay, so some people left and some new people joined. Some people joined and some left in 2003 and so on for all the companies. Okay, let's see the questions. Question number one is, if the ratio of the number of male to female employees in company B at the end of 2003 was 5:6. What was the number of female employees in the company B at the end of 2003? So first we need to find out how many employees were there at the end of 2003. Okay, when we do that, we see that the ratio of male to female is given, then we can find the number of females in company B at the end of 2003. Okay, so to find the number of employees in company B at the end of 2003, we will add all these and subtract these two from that. So we have 148, 172, 188. This will be 8, 16, 8, 1, 15, 20, 0, 2, 5. 508, from this you have to subtract 60 plus 96, that is 156. So this will be 2, 50 minus 15 is 35. So this is 352. Okay, 352, male and female are in the ratio of 5:6. So number of females will be 6 by 11 into 352. So we have 11 ones are, 11 threes are 33 and 2 is 22. So then we have 192. Option D is the correct answer. Okay. Next, question number 2. What was the total number of employees in company A at the end of 2004? So again, we know how to find that. So in 2004, in company A. Okay. So take the total of all this, and subtract the two. So we have 161, 148, 135, 112. This will be 6, 1, 5, 1, 5. 556 minus 58, 69 and 88. 88, 16. 16 and 9 is 25. Okay, so we have 21. 215. Subtract 215 from this, we'll get 143. 341 option E. Question number 3. The number of employees in company E at the end of 2002, at the end of 2002 is what percent more than the number of employees in the company C at the end of 2002? So first let's find for company E at the end of 2002, how many will be there? 191 minus 50 will be 141. 141 plus 128, 962. So 269 employees are there in company E at the end of 2002. For company C it is 161 minus 90 will be 71. 71 plus 179, 0, 1, 5, 250. Okay, so we have 250 employees in company C and 269 in company E. What do we need to find now? In company E is what percent more? X is what percent more than Y? For that, we need to take the difference first. Difference will be 90 compared to company C. C is 250. 250 into 100%. So we have 15 into 2, 15 into 5. So that is 38 by 5, or we can take it as 7, 3 by 5. 7, 3 by 5, option D. Okay, question number 4. In which of the given company? Now we need to find for A, B and D at the end of 2002 to tell for which company it was the highest. Okay, so here 148 minus 58 is 90. 90 plus 160. Is 251. 161 is 251. For B, 172 minus 60 is 112. 112 plus 148 is 260. Okay. Next for D, 208 minus 60. 208 minus 60 is 148. 148 plus 116 will be 4162. 264. So we see E is the highest, option E. Question number 5. What is the average number of employees who joined company D during all the given years? Who joined company D? Okay, so take the total of this and divide it by 5. So we have... 116... 208, 169, 142, 155. 8 into 10, 10 and 15, 25, 30, 0, 3, 3, 4, 4 and 6, 10, 19. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 790. 790 divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Divided by 5. Will be 158, option E. Okay, so with this we are done with all the questions. I'll see you tomorrow with a new topic at the same time. Thank you very much and all the best for your endeavor. So do you have any doubts? Okay, so we'll end the class for today. Thank you. Okay, Nadir, we'll discuss it tomorrow. Okay, thank you and bye for now.